thanks for inviting me to talk to you about SAP's Business Technology Platform, the innovation platform that we are using both within SAP to build business innovations and which we are also providing to our customers and partners to do exactly the same thing. Why are we doing it intentionally? I left one or two of these marketing slides in because I also see that many customers would like to know why we are doing it. And the goal always is to be able to deliver rapid business innovations. That is what all of my customers are interested in. They want to be part of the digital transformation. They have their digital transformation agenda because they know that those companies who relentlessly execute on their innovation agenda are a lot more successful in the market than those ones who basically stick with certain fixed business processes and are not able to adjust. So what does the business technology bring to the table? First of all, the business technology platform is a reflection of SAP's more than 50 years of business experience. So the key capabilities that we want to bring to the table is to accelerate and move applications to the cloud. Why is this important? Especially when you look into what happened in 2023 in the area of artificial intelligence. And you also understand that there are in Europe, there is not one data center which is large enough to calculate one of these large language models. Then it is completely impossible to run these kind of capabilities in an on-premise deployment. Therefore, for the years to come, we will see a lot of innovations being predominantly available in the cloud, and we want to make that possible. At the same time, the challenge is to keep the, and I say in brackets, ERP core clean. What does that mean? Sometimes in the past, an ERP core got bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. The much smarter way to do it is to define fixed boundaries for such a kernel and to say, which capabilities do I need to deliver within the kernel and which capabilities can I build so-called loosely coupled on the business technology platform? That reduces the complexity of the kernel quite significantly, makes testing and quality assurance measures a lot easier, and therefore building capabilities on the business technology platform to keep the ERP core clean is one of the key themes that you also see SAP following through. The third aspect is to optimize and automate business processes. That is what our customers expect from SAP, that we help them to A, provide an inventory of state-of-the-art business processes, end-to-end business processes, but then also to automate those elements which are handled, for example, manually today. To give you an example, which I also used in my other presentation, many of my customers receive their orders via email. And one way to use automation here is to write a bot, and that is definitely not rocket science. And my friends from Coldstone can help you with that. They have a lot of experience in that area. The bot would read the incoming emails, look at the content, decide whether this is a sales order, yes or no. And if yes, recognize the content and call the API from Business One, Business by Design S4, and trigger the creation of the sales order. Last point is all about data and to make better decisions based on the data that you have collected. Therefore, everything that you need to manage the data, manage the quality of the data, but then also to apply all of the required analytics. That is the fourth point on this picture. So if we look at the business technology platform, I said it is an intuitive, modern development environment, both for low-code and pro-code developers. So low-code developers are rather those ones who are assembling a solution based on existing building blocks. The pro-code are those ones who are, for example, using a cloud-native development environment like Node.js and building entire applications. And SAP's business technology brings all of that to the table. The aspects of it is we have the area of application development, and I talked about also the automation part. Very important is this middle box here with integration, because as I said, no SAP application ever stands on its own. You have, for example, additional extended warehouse management systems. You may have external web shop components. For sure, you will have communication arrangements with your bank. Most likely also government wants to have certain data from you. And all of that is done via the integration capability of the business technology platform. And as mentioned, data and analytics is what, at the end of the day, my customers want. They want a robust set of processes, but they say, we also want to see evidence that we start to make smarter decisions, and that goes hand in hand with the artificial intelligence capabilities baked into the system. I could go here in a greater level of detail, but I would not go into that level of detail, but rather talk at a higher level about what we are doing with application development. So, as mentioned, no SAP solution is ever complete. Nearly every company needs additional capabilities. It can start with simple scenarios like a few more fields, a few more data elements, a bit of additional logic. And that is what we are addressing with SAP Build, so that companies can extend the solution in the way how they want to do it. And here you see a short visualization, how you create a form, how you wire them up, and how you add a bit of additional business logic. And that then really allows you to personalize your SAP solution to your specific needs. If we quickly look into the automation side of the house, then on the left side, we have here two tools. The one is Signavio, which we are using for business process modeling. That is rather something that my larger customers of the upper mid-market are interested about. My smaller B1 and by design customers rather stick with the libraries that SAP provides them. But that doesn't matter, because at the end of the day, you end up with a set of processes, forms, and you want to automate as much as possible. So you can build workflows that you say, I stick with the example of the email processing. You receive the email, you analyze the content of the email. If you find content from which you can derive a sales order, you then use the automation capability to trigger a form. You apply certain business rules. For example, if the order form comes in the form of an image, then you can also apply document extraction services. That would be the intelligence part of it, where the document looks at the image, extracts the relevant information, hands it over to the reporting process automation step, and then you process that task and you see that it's executed in the system. And this simply helps companies to use their human resources as effectively as possible. Integration is an endless, or would be an endless presentation. Just to take the most important points, you need, if we start in the middle with a business-to-business integration. where you have EDI-based scenarios. You have integration into non-SAP application connectivity, where you also need to have the security side of the house. You have event-driven automation, where you subscribe to a certain event, for example, a sales order got confirmed, and then you receive a control point where you can say, I'm adding certain logic here that I want to use. So that as a high-level perspective, for you, it is important to know that SAP's cloud suite integration, as we are describing it today, is bringing all of these integration capabilities to the table. Data and analytics, the flagship product there is SAP Analytics Cloud, one of the built-in components of S/4HANA Public Cloud. That is the instrumentation that also we are using for in-app analytics, so be it any kind of reporting and forecasting scenarios. We also have for our larger customers data management and data warehousing capabilities, something that where SAP has been a market leader for decades. And obviously, all of that is happening on SAP's in-memory database, HANA, which allows us to do many of these aggregations at the press of a button. Good. Let's look for a moment at artificial intelligence. The key message here is the challenge of artificial intelligence is so large, and we are just scratching the surface, that SAP decided this is nothing that SAP can do on its own, specifically when it comes to building out large language models or vector databases. And therefore, you see here in the lower part of the image, you see a lot of logos of partners who we are working at, be it, for example, IBM with Watson, be it Microsoft with their relationship to OpenAI, but also AWS, Anthropic, Cohere, Databricks, Aleph Alpha. So what SAP is doing, we are then adding this AI foundation, which is basically an abstraction layer. So that as an application developer who is sitting here in the upper layers, I don't need to worry about which model I'm going to use at the end of the day, because I need, as an application developer, I need the degree of freedom to say I built something and then I try it out maybe first with GPT 3.5, because that may be the most cost-effective option. But I definitely also want to try it out with IBM Watson. I want to try it out with GPT 4.0 and look at the results that I get. So all of these line of business solutions, be it cloud ERP, be it capital management, be it the purchasing solution, be it the customer relationship management solution, all of these line of business solutions consume this AI foundation layer and then provide the outcome up. And one way to present that is to use SAP Joule, which is a chatbot, which is a co-pilot environment, which allows us a completely new way of interacting with the end user. So the key message here is SAP's value add is that we provide this abstraction layer and then make these capabilities available to all of the applications. Business technology platform is about how do I build applications, but at the same time, it is also the question, where do I then execute my application? Here again, slight differences between the mid-market and the upper mid-market and large companies. My typically lower mid-market customers in the B1 and by design space, mostly they say, look, I don't have a specific preference. You ensure that you execute my business processes on a very robust environment. And SAP, that's your job. in the business one world, it is even a bit simpler than there, where companies like Coldstone talk to their customers and say, look, either you operate the infrastructure on your own, bracket, which I'm not recommending, bracket, or Coldstone does it on their behalf. And then you can see whether you want to, or which kind of cloud environment you want to use it. In the large enterprise world, the picture is different. There my customers say, look, we made a strategic decision. For example, I picked just one for Azure from Microsoft. And then they say, to make sure that we run both our own applications that we have written on our own, plus the SAP applications in the same cloud environment, therefore, we expect that BTP also runs on Azure, and that is the case. And then on these kind of partner services, be it Azure, be it AWS, we then run all of the different BTP services that we have visualized here. Business Technology Platform is operated out of multiple data centers from the various providers, so that also for customers who need a very low latency, we can provide an environment where this is possible. Obviously, all of these operations are certified. That would be another day-long presentation, starting with ISO 27001 and ending up for my friends in the United States with FedRAMP and weapons in transit standards that are required for certain military companies, public sector requirements. So SAP has many of these certificates and can therefore ensure that your data for whatever version of BTP you're using is in the best possible hands. That said, thanks a lot for your attention on SAP's Business Technology Platform. So in a nutshell, whenever you need to extend solutions with own capabilities, with automation scenarios, with artificial intelligence scenarios, or with data analytics capabilities, the Business Technology Platform provides you all of these capabilities, and we operate them in a highly secured environment. That much from my side. Thanks a lot.